Hey guys, today I am going to start a brand new Let's Play series. This is going to be modded Minecraft. I've actually gone through and selected certain mods that I thought would be pretty fun to try out, and I've loaded them up together here, and I've come up with my own customized modding experience. And we're going to check out those mods right now so you can see what mods I will be running. Of course, I've got these first three. They all are required when you're downloading Minecraft Forge, which is the loader that I use to install these mods. And then the fourth one, Code Chicken Core, is required for not enough items. And this mod is basically one that allows you to see the name of any item or block in the game when you're looking at it, and gives you a plugin for recipe viewers too. So you can click on an item in your inventory, and it'll tell you what the recipe is to craft it. And then I've got BiblioCraft, which has some awesome furniture and other cool things. Biomes aplenty. It's almost a requirement, I feel like, if you're going to be doing modded Minecraft. There's so many biomes, like 70, 80 biomes in here. And it has new blocks in each of those biomes. That's going to be really fun, because one of the things I love to do in Minecraft is just explore. So I want to explore and find as many of these biomes as I can. Chocolate Quest is also known as the Better Dungeons mod. And it has some really cool structures that are generated with some insanely awesome dungeons with sweet loot inside and awesome bosses in the middle. That's going to be fun whenever we run across those. I'm really excited about that. Forestry I installed because it does have bees and it has trees, which that's kind of cool. But most importantly, this has the miner's backpack and the digger's backpack, which I am really excited about being able to use, because those allow you to automatically pick up ores and dirt and cobblestone and things like that as you're mining. It instantly picks up into your inventory and puts it into these backpacks, which gives you extra inventory slots, so it lets you have longer mining trips, which that's the most annoying thing for me in Minecraft is when I run out of space after mining for a long time. I'll just have to make sure I don't die while I'm mining, because that would defeat the whole purpose. But if I do die, the gravestone mod is awesome. What it does is it actually gives you a marked spot of where your last death is, so you can see it and head straight towards it once you respawn after dying, and it puts all of your items into a gravestone in the ground. So you can go back, and if you can actually break the gravestone, all your items will pop out and you can pick them up again. So it's really nice because it doesn't have the limitation that Minecraft has where when you wait a couple minutes after you enter the chunk, all your items disappear if you don't get to them in time. This one will keep them there until you go and actually break the gravestone. And you can have more than one gravestone at once, so if you die going back to get your items, it'll still have another gravestone for you. And then I have Ray's Minimap, which is an awesome mod. It gives me a minimap on my screen, and I can get waypoints, so if I find something cool and I want to mark the spot, I can actually mark it down on my map so I can come back and find it later. Which is going to be, I think, essential if we're having all these different biomes and everything, so I'm going to be using that a lot too. And then Roguelike Dungeons is another dungeon mod, which has some awesome randomized dungeons that it spawns with an awesome tower above ground, and then underground it just goes so many different layers. There's crazy loot down there and spawners and crazy mobs. It's pretty sweet. And then the Twilight Forest, which is another awesome mod that adds a whole new dimension. And I cannot wait to get into the Twilight Forest. That's one of my other main goals in this game. So those are the mods that I'm using right now. I may end up adding more mods as we go. One of the main ones that I have used before is Thaumcraft. I wanted to hold off on that one until I felt a little more comfortable with kind of how to use all these mods together. But that one is definitely a possibility down the road. And I've also thought about adding in the Natural Disasters mod, which has like tornadoes come up and earthquakes and meteorites and all that stuff randomly. So that would be a cool random element to add to my game and keep me on my toes, because you never know when that could strike. That could be fun too. And yeah, there's a couple other mods that I'm kind of considering, but for now this is what we're going to roll with. And I'm going to go ahead and start a new single player world and get going. So let's do it. Alright, so I realized I forgot one more mod to show you. It goes along with the NEI, the Not Enough Items mod, and it's called Wyla. It stands for What Am I Looking At, which it shows you, of course, what you're looking at. When your cursor hovers over a block type, it'll show you which mod it came from, whether it's the vanilla Minecraft or if it's from a different mod pack that you've installed. And also, so it's pretty sweet, because when you see the name of an item, then you can look up with Not Enough Items, what that is and what you can use it to craft with and such. It's pretty sweet. So let's go ahead and start a new world.